Hello friends and my dear students, welcome back to my channel Phoenix Physics. Today we are going to learn average velocity and average speed. We have already studied about distance and displacement. What is distance? Distance is the actual path length traveled by an object in a given interval of time during the motion. Then what about displacement? Shortest distance between final and initial position of the object in a given interval of time. Once you know distance and displacement, we can easily calculate speed and velocity. What is the formula for speed? Speed is equal to distance traveled by time taken. And you know that speed is a scalar quantity and the unit is meter second minus 1. Then what is the formula for velocity? Velocity is equal to displacement divided by time. Here also unit is same, that is m meter second minus 1. Here velocity is a vector quantity. You know that vector quantity means it has magnitude and direction. Simply we can say speed plus direction gives velocity. Distance, displacement, speed, velocity, these are all the basic terms in kinematics. But our topic is average velocity and average speed. Why do we need average velocity or average speed? For example, a car covering 60 km in an hour is said to have average speed of 60 km per hour. Even though he sped up and slowed down for traffic and didn't maintain proper 60 km per hour all the time. That is, he cannot drive one single speed at every single moment. In that case, we can use average speed or average velocity. How do you calculate average velocity? When an object is in motion, the position of the object changes with time, right? Look at this graph. This graph is plotted between time and displacement. Consider a particle P whose position vector is r1. You know that position vector should start from the origin. Corresponding time is t1 for this point P. After some time interval, the particle at P moves to Q. Here, the position vector is r2 and the corresponding time is t2. How do you calculate the displacement vector or displacement? You know that displacement is the shortest distance between final and initial position. Here, this is my final position, this is my initial position. You have to draw the shortest distance like this. So, this is my displacement vector. It is denoted by the letter delta r. So, delta r is equal to r2 minus r1. Up to this clear? So, how do you define average velocity? Average velocity is the ratio of displacement vector to the corresponding time interval. So, average velocity is equal to the ratio of displacement vector delta r to the corresponding time interval, that is del t. What is delta r? Difference between final position and initial position, that is r2 minus r1. What is del t? Difference between t2 and t1, that is del t. What about the direction? Velocity has magnitude as well as direction. Here the direction of average velocity is in the direction of displacement vector. Average velocity can have either positive or negative value. How do you calculate average speed? Average speed is defined as ratio of total path length to the total time interval. Here average speed is always a positive quantity. This is very important. Just now I said average velocity can have either positive value or negative value, but average speed has only positive value or positive quantity. Why? You know that speed has only magnitude. So speed has only positive value. Based on the concept, one example problem is given. Consider an object traveling in a semicircular path from point O to point P in 5 seconds as shown in the figure given below. Calculate the average velocity and average speed. You know the formula. Average velocity, V average, is equal to delta R divided by delta T. What is delta R? The difference between final and initial position. Here the particle starts from O and reaches P. So this is our final position and this is our initial position. So you can write it as Rp minus R0, RO, Rp minus RO divided by del T. Here the particle starts from the origin. So RO is equal to 0. What about Rp value? The magnitude is 10 centimeter, that is given. So Rp is equal to 10. What is this Rp? Rp is nothing but the position vector. You know that the position vector should start from the origin. So what about the direction? This position vector is in the x direction. So you can write it as 10i. 10i vector. Substitute this value in equation 1, that is 10i minus 0 divided by 5 second, that is 10i by 5 2i. The average velocity is in the positive x direction. Then how do you calculate average speed? What's the formula for average speed? Total path length divided by time interval. Here the path is semicircle in shape. Okay, so the particle start from O and reaches P and travels in the semicircular path. What is the circumference of semicircle? That is pi r. If it is circle, means circumference of the circle formula is 2 pi r. If it is semicircle, means circumference of the circle is pi r. Substitute here. So path length pi r divided by time interval is t. T value you know, 5 seconds. Then what about r? Look at this graph. Here up to OP is 10 centimeter. So this is nothing but the diameter of the circle. We need radius. Just divide 10 centimeter by 2. It gives radius r, that is 5. Substitute the value, that is pi into r is 5 divided by t is 5. Cancel out this. You can get pi. Or you can write 3.14. Average speed is equal to 3.14. Here, average speed is greater than the magnitude of average velocity. Here, average velocity magnitude is 2. Here, 3.14. So, average speed is greater than the magnitude of average velocity. Up to this clear? I hope this video is useful to you. If you like my video, please share and subscribe my video. Thank you.